A piece to every soul, a piece to every soul, peace to the oversoul, yeah, peace to every soul, a piece to every spirit, you know us when you hear it.
Hi everyone, welcome. So this is Juliet Tang, and I am joined by Jordan Bates. We are here to share some tips on how to stay empowered and present and sovereign during this time of uncertainty. So Jordan is the founder of Refine the Mind and co-owner of High Existence. He teaches creators how to dissolve fear, reclaim power, follow joy, and be free. In 2013, he moved to Asia to teach English, embarking on a nomadic journey that has led him to 32 countries. Since then, he's co-built a multiple six-figure business, reached millions of people online, and became a prosperous entrepreneur. So Jordan is a writer, artist, coach, and freedom hacker. He is endlessly curious about how we can liberate ourselves on every level to shift into a life that aligns with our highest joy. So this is a very interesting live that we are doing right now, given the circumstance and what is currently happening in our world. It is really our intention to to share what is going to help so many people navigate the fear and the uncertainty and how to reclaim our power at this point. So I am a business mentor, and I know my audience is mostly conscious entrepreneurs, coaches, mentors, consultants, healers, and transformational leaders. I know that Jordan has more of a mixed audience. So what we're about to share is, it really has everything to do. It's for everyone. It's not just for business owners, because I believe this is high time that we come together as a society, as one, to understand that everything that we do affects each other, and everything that we be affects everything that we do on all levels. So what we're about to share can help you reclaim your power in your health, in your money, in your business or career. And it's really, our highest intention to help you operate from a higher place than this massive fear and panic that is going on in the world right now. So you're in the right place if you just want to tune into something that is going to raise your vibration and perhaps shift your energy, your mindset, and where you are right now. You're absolutely in the right place if you want to learn some practical tips to navigate uncertainty, establish stronger energetic boundaries, and make conscious and empowered decisions in all areas of your life. So throughout this live, we would love, love, love for you to participate. It means to like, love, comment, drop your insights, ask questions, and just do whatever it is that you feel so that you understand this is a co-creation. This is not going to be just us broadcasting. We would love, love, love for you guys to join us in this co-creation, stay engaged, and also, have a conversation. Same for those who are watching the replay. Please hashtag replay. And, if you have a comment, make sure that you drop that so we can circle back and answer your comments. Whew, that was a lot. So much has been coming through for me, and I'm certain it is for Jordan as well, because he was just telling me that he was writing this epic, turning into a book at this point, but a lot of information is coming through. And we have a lot of conscious leaders in our community that I feel this is time for us to kind of really share what is going on and support each other, not from the place of just like, let's collaborate, we can make more money this way. It is time to build conscious communities, and it's time for all of us to understand that oneness is really the only truth that there is, right? The unity. Mm-hmm. So we're going to start with Jordan, and let's hear what he has to say about how you can navigate this time.
Yeah, thank you so much, Juliet. Really appreciate being here. As you said, what is happening right now is so powerful. It feels like this time of accelerated change where really a giant mirror is being held up, and it almost feels like, it feels like nature is orchestrating a kind of collective rite of passage right now in a global culture that has forgotten the power of ritual and rites of passage. It seems like this is coming up right now, and it's just bringing up all of our stuff. It's holding up such a mirror, and it's just bringing up all of our stuff at such an accelerated pace. And so it almost feels like we're quantum leaping right now into some kind of new paradigm. And the pace of change is so fast that it's dizzying, and a lot of people are getting sick with it. And I think right now a lot of people are realizing that the vital importance of this skill set of being able to hold space for whatever is arising in experience. That's really one of the core things that I want to talk about, is the skill of holding space for whatever is arising in experience. Because right now, so much is coming up. So many energies are coming through the body. There's, you know, there's fear, there's uncertainty, there's confusion, there's panic. There may be excitement and joy and wonder and appreciation. There's so many things. And if you don't know, if you don't start to practice learning how to hold space for whatever is arising, you could easily become overwhelmed by what is happening. So most fundamentally, for me, to hold space for whatever is arising is to start learning to see that every single feeling, every single experience is really okay. Every single thing that arises in your body, in your experience, in your mind, every thought, it's really okay. You want to learn how to occupy this space of unconditionally non-judgmental awareness, this space of kind of pure neutral awareness, where you're not choosing anything over anything else. You're just allowing everything to be precisely as it is right now. And you're not, you learn how to disidentify from the content of experience as well, instead of being completely at the mercy of this emotional roller coaster that might be occurring within your system. You learn how to become the space in which the emotions and the energies are arising and moving through you. You learn how to drop the words and the stories of the mind and just go into the body and feel whatever you're feeling as fully as possible. I think that right now, Letting Go by David Hawkins would be an amazing book for a lot of people to read if they want to learn how to hold space for whatever is arising, because the letting go technique that he describes in that book is such a beautiful practice of basically doing exactly what I'm talking about, dropping back into a space of pure, neutral, unconditionally accepting, unconditionally loving awareness, and just feeling whatever is arising in your body as fully as you can, and beginning to realize that when you feel your feelings as fully as possible, without wishing to change them or modify them, and without judging them, this is how you gradually dissolve and release whatever is no longer useful, whatever is no longer integrous for you. And this is how you reintegrate a lot of the power that you've given away, a lot of the power that's been trapped by repressing whatever is now coming to the surface. So the feeling is the healing. Right now, we're all, whether we like it or not, just being forced to feel a lot of the things that we hadn't wanted to feel. There's a really primal fear of death coming to the surface right now for a lot of people, fear of death and disease. And the fear of death, arguably, is the root fear underlying all other fears. The fear of death is so core, so fundamental, and it's really a beautiful gift to be able to go into this fear and really feel it fully and really find out what are you afraid of? Find out what is this boogeyman of death that we're so scared of, and go into those feelings, feel them. And then on the other side of that, you come through, you come out so much more fearless and sovereign and able to face whatever comes. The more fully you accept death, the more fully you then affirm life and can really show up and really affirm this opportunity as a human being. So I think that skill set of holding space for whatever arises is extremely fundamental right now. And another point I want to mention is shadow work. Right now, so many people are being triggered by so many things. So many people are, we're now entering this kind of bizarre environment where a lot of people are self-policing each other. There's a lot of shaming going on. If anyone is questioning certain things about the dominant narrative about what's happening, or if anyone is refusing to self-quarantine as rigorously, there, you know, there's a lot of people projecting and wanting to say, hey, you're the bad guy, you're fucking it all up right now, you're terrible, you're evil, or so. This is really a chance to begin to realize that all judgment is self-judgment, and all hatred is self-hatred. Anything that you point to that is supposedly outside of you and you say, that's the problem, I hate that, I judge that, that's wrong, that thing is also within you. There's nothing outside of us that is not also within us. As Juliet said, everything is fundamentally one. And in the deepest level, there's no separation between any of us. So whatever, as Carl Jung said, whatever irritates us can lead us to an understanding of ourselves. Whatever is triggering you, whatever is really difficult to look at right now, that's pointing you. That's a pointer pointing you in the direction of actually where you need to go to integrate more of yourself, more of your wholeness, and to reclaim more of your power. Joseph Campbell said, the cave you fear to enter holds the treasure you seek. Yes. It's going into those difficult feelings and those triggers, and realizing that what is triggering you is a part of you, is a very powerful practice indeed. And then the last thing I'll briefly mention is simply learning to dwell in a space of not knowing. Mm. There are so many narratives swirling around right now, and the mind really wants to grasp onto one and grasp onto a coherent story to create this false sense of security in the midst of what is happening. But if you can learn to drop back into the space of not needing to know, the space of being comfortable not knowing, and just holding space for many narratives without clinging to any of them or without pushing any of them away, if you can kind of enter this trans narrative space, and this is similar to that space of in which you can hold space for whatever is arising, you can actually then realize that none of these narratives are fundamentally separate from you. They're all swirling around in the collective consciousness and the collective unconscious. They're all a part of us. And the sooner we can learn to hold space for the entirety of planet Earth and the entirety of what is happening here, the sooner we can transcend the duality consciousness that keeps us locked into these kind of war and fighting dynamics during a catastrophe. And the sooner we can rise into the unity consciousness that embraces everything that's happening and is able to just hold fast to the center and be the sovereign warrior in the eye of the storm. So,
yeah, I love that. And when you were mentioning that everything that is triggering us from outside of us, it's because there's something in us that is being triggered. You know, it just reminds me that even in business coaching and coaching people with money, there are some aspects of shadow work, which really is about, you know, the reason why we are so triggered these days is because we're seeing our own shadows being magnified in front of our eyes. And there's no right or wrong in it, because collectively as a human species, each of us holds on to some type of shadow. It's just embedded in our psyche. So right now, and both of us work with plant medicine, but you don't need to drink ayahuasca to take away a lot from, you know, from what we're broadcasting. You know, right now, our collective is going through this gigantic, massive purge. And the way that I'm looking at it is that it is purging everything that is not in alignment with what all of the, you know, the conscious entrepreneurs, the leaders, what a lot of us have been talking about, which is entering a new paradigm. So, what I want to say is that what I'm about to share, I do not ever claim what I'm sharing is the absolute truth, because I feel like that is taking away your authority. But I honor that each of us is connected with the highest truth that is available to us at this time. So because each of us is, there is this collective journey that is happening right now, and there's this individual journey that we're going on right now, which is exactly what it's like, you know, in the plant medicine journey, collective and individual. So I want you to just take away what really resonates with your soul from this transmission, because the only thing that I can say that I know for sure is that the message that I'm sharing is in integrity with my highest truth right now. So personally, I couldn't agree more with Jordan. What he shared right now is that I do see a lot of finger pointing. So in the business, you know, in the business world, I see people kind of like shaming people for wanting to sell, or shaming people for not wanting to sell, market their services. I'm going to say this. There are people in this world right now that need to be processing their stuff that is coming up. This might mean, you know, punching the pillows. This might mean crying. This might mean just like calling someone on the phone and just talking about it. There are people who need to sit with the fear that is coming up right now, because collectively we've been taught to only operate from our heads so much that none of us, like most of us, are so not, we're disconnected from our bodies, and our bodies are where the emotions are. There are people who need to practice stillness and chaos right now, and there are people who are called to lead right now. So it is okay if you're one of those people, and it is okay if you are all of these things at once, because I know for certain that there were, you know, moments, and I'm broadcasting from New York, where I am in the heart of the beast, you know, I'm in the center of the very pandemic that is going on right now. There are days, or there are moments, that I am all of those things. So what I'm about to share is the work that I've been doing for years, and how I can establish very, very clear energetic boundaries so that I do not get pulled into this panic right now. Something about energetic boundaries that I feel a lot of us are kind of forced to understand and practice diligently right now is that the first thing that comes up is we need to understand what is ours and what is not ours. On the highest level, we are all of it. On the highest level, everything that is outside of us is also inside of us. But now I want to move back to your individual reality. And your individual reality is that you're going on your own journey, whether it is a growth acceleration or some type of quantum leaping or some type of ego death. Your own journey right now is your own journey. So the question that I always like to ask is, how am I being proactive rather than reactive? Meaning, I can easily turn on the news and look at all of the bad things that are happening in the world right now and immediately get sucked into that reality. Or I can stay very mindful with what it is that I choose to do from the moment I wake up until the moment that I go to bed. And I can say to myself, you know what, Juliet, in the morning, you're still going to go through your morning rituals, no matter what, because this is the time that I can stay empowered in my own energy and understand what is going on inside of me that might not be a part of what other people are going through right now. It might mean that I say to myself, and this is something that I'm very, very strict with myself, that I'm only checking social media maybe 3 times a day during these specific times. I'm only checking the news 3 times a day during these specific times. And when I go, before I check the news, I check in with myself and I ask myself, on a scale of 0 to 10, 0 being not at all, I'm all over the place and there's no judgment, 10 being I am taking full ownership of my mind and my energetic state. Where am I? Because if you're at a 0 and you're checking the news and you have a friend on Facebook who is like doom and gloom and talking about her downloads, that the world is going to end and everybody's going to die, and we all have a friend like that, that I hope you unfriended, immediately your unconscious mind, that information is passing your conscious mind straight into your unconscious mind. And you're going to be very, very reactive to that, because you're going to have an emotional reaction to it. And that emotional reaction, if you're not censoring yourself, can quickly turn into a belief. And if that belief is not something that you actively, you know, work on or release, it becomes a part of your belief system. So part of taking responsibility of really establishing very firm energetic boundaries is to understand what it's like to take 100% radical self-responsibility of your mind, your energetic state, your choices, your thoughts, your emotions, and your actions. One of my favorite authors, Wallace Wattles, he is the author of The Science of Getting Rich. He basically said, you know, there's a quote, a thought is a substance producing the thing that is imagined by the thought. It literally means that, you know, behind what is currently happening. And for people who do work with plant medicine, you guys know that the reality that we're seeing right now, that we're experiencing right now, is literally 1% of the matrix. There is 99% of what is going on behind the veil of reality that we're not seeing. So energetically, each thought, as harmless as it can look, is actually something that produces matter. This is the alchemy of energy into matter. So for me, when I talk about, you know, we are still the creators and creatrixes, it really means, what thoughts am I creating at the moment that I'm actually sending out to the universe? Because the way that the thought works is that it's two ways. We send it into the universe and then it comes back to us by, you know, law of vibration. Whatever it is that we're emanating, the vibration that we're emanating, we are kind of magnetizing the same, you know, like, the opportunities, people, events that are in alignment with that vibration. So part of this is really understand how powerful our thoughts are, how powerful we are. And this is not about bypassing, because I know there are some spiritual people who are like, oh, everything is love and light, everything is great. Absolutely not. This is about feeling what needs to be felt in a place, like Jordan mentioned, where you're holding space for that. And the way that I coach my clients through this is understand and tapping into our multidimensionality. So there's the human part of us that is freaking out right now, that is like, oh my God, how am I going to do grocery shopping? I can't go out, I'm being quarantined. We're not just this human part. There's also this aspect of who we be that is multidimensional. Some people call it the spirit, you know, the spirit. Some people call it the higher self. There is that bigger part of us that is currently holding space for that smaller part of us. So partially, this is planting the awareness that, you know what, while we are thinking these thoughts and feeling these emotions, just understand that these things don't necessarily define who we are, the totality of who we are. So being very, very mindful with our habits right now, being very mindful with what we're feeding our mind right now, what type of emotional reactions we're having right now, what type of judgments we're coming up with, and how we're just choosing to go about our day, our business, or if you're working from home, how you're interacting with your coworkers. Are you, you know, like spreading news, you know, a lot of like, you know, hypothesis right now to other people, unconsciously causing a fear reaction? All of these things are part of self-responsibility. All of these things are part of us being sovereign in our consciousness. And I'm going to say that Albert Einstein said, imagination is more powerful than knowledge. Meaning, if we are sitting home imagining the worst case scenario, that is producing something, right? That is going into the universe, versus none of us really know what is going to happen. So we have, each of us has this creative power. So use your imagination wisely, I would say. Use your thoughts wisely and really stay connected to your own individual reality, what is coming up for you and what needs to be processed at this time, instead of getting really sucked into other people's journeys. And this is something that happens a lot in plant medicine for me. I used to get sucked into other people's journeys until I realized that, you know what, we're kind of just like, we need to make sure that we are connected with the highest aspect of who we are, instead of just getting lost in this noise right now. So a question that I will really ask a lot of you to ask yourself is, what is it like for me to take ownership of my mind and my energetic state right now. You know, what am I responsible for that I can shift and change? What am I not responsible for changing right now? Again, especially in the spiritual community, there are a lot of people who are currently operating from the shadow of their savior or healer archetype that believe that they need to be saving the world right now and they're responsible for other people's emotions. And there are a lot of people who are doing it right now without even understanding that they're doing it. And they end up feeling exhausted. They end up feeling like their energetic state has been infiltrated. So really ask yourself, what am I responsible for? Like, what is it that I'm really in charge of? And at the end of the day, for me, what I'm really in charge of is my own reality. It's my thoughts. It's my emotions. It's my choices. It's my actions. Unfortunately, I am not in charge of, you know, telling that guy who's walking on the street to be social distancing, right? Unless I'm in front of him. But there are things that I am not in charge of right now. So make sure that you have a very clear stand as to where you are, what you can control, what you can't control. Because when it comes to the mind, and I've been working with the mind for years, when it comes to the mind, if the mind is not in check, it can actually be highly destructive. I see destructive in a way that it is not evil. It's more like a servant. And I'm a huge Osho fan. And I remember he said something that's all about the mind is a beautiful, beautiful servant and a terrible master. This is not the time to let your little critter mind take control of who you are. Because I do believe on a global level, on a more spiritual level, on a consciousness level, collectively, we're going through a gigantic ego death right now. And part of ego death is understanding that we are not our minds, right? And I don't want to get into the super like nothing matters, you know, blah, 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 because that is spiritual bypassing. What I'm pointing out is we are bigger than the stories that are being repeated in here right now. And I'm going to show you a way for you to actually act from more like from a heart-centered place than the mind. So being a business coach, I like to see everything as an investment. What we're thinking, how we're feeling, how we're reacting, or how we're responding is still an investment. When I say investment, most people think about time or money, but the highest currency that we have right now is our energy. So the question is, what is the best, given this is already happening? You know, instead of like blaming someone that this has happened, what is the best way for me to use or to invest my time and energy right now? And usually there are two choices. I can sit here and sing a song about doom and gloom, or I can choose to invest my time and energy wisely, maybe to catch up, you know, on a book that I haven't finished reading, or to call up friends from the past. And again, this is in alignment with if you need to be processing your emotions, process them, but understand, have the awareness to understand that everything, every moment, however we are being, is an investment because the future is completely created in the present moment. So whatever it is that we are investing into right now is shaping up our future. Whether we like it or not, we all play by these rules of the universe, right? So if for those of you that are feeling like this is your time to rise, that this is the time to create a new earth, this is the time to lead humanity into its next level, I mean, really, really, really be very conscious as to how you're investing your time and energy right now. One thing that I know for certain, and there's so much uncertainty right now, one thing that I know for certain is that the truth did not change. The universal laws did not change. The fact that we are still sovereign creators and creatrixes did not change. The fact that all of us are expressions and extensions of spirit, which is infinite, which is all being, which is, you know, which contains infinite amount of possibilities, that did not change. So in order for us to, and some of us are thinking about creative solutions, maybe to bring in income or to help out a family member, in order for us to come up with even a creative solution, we cannot use the same consciousness that created that problem. We just can't. So part of this is understand that how can I separate my energy from what is going on right now? How can I tap into my own resources? How can I align with that highest vision and version of who I be? And how can I tell a circumstance from the truth? The circumstance is that there's a goddamn virus out there and it really sucks. And it's destroyed, you know, in a way. It is kind of like destroying in people's lives on a certain level. There are people who are sick. There are people who lost their jobs. Each of us has been impacted very, very deeply. But understand that that is still a circumstance. The truth is that we are still the creator. Virus or no virus, we are still the creator and the creatrix. We are still energy in form. We're still God in human form. So I would especially like, you know, like say to some people, do not believe every single download that you're getting, especially if you've been operating from a place of distress or stress or fear. Because from what I know about spirit, it never ever communicates in fear. It always communicates in the voice of love. So what I'm seeing is that there's a lot of projection right now on social media and the world all over the place, right? Collectively, a lot of us are processing. And for some of us that are not comfortable with this process, we are projecting because it's a psychological defense mechanism. There's absolutely no judgment because all of us have projected at some point in our lives. But this is the time to be aware how we have played a part in the old paradigm and how we can play a part in the new earth. Because entering 2020, I know so many of us came in here with the big visions where like it's a new decade. You know, finally, the old systems and institutions are collapsing. We're reforming the healthcare system. We're going to, you know, build a new economy. We've come into 2020 with these big dreams and visions because so many of us feel that, you know, we play an important role in the awakening of humanity. You know, however, whatever, which area you choose, that's your choice. My choice right now, business, money, you know, marketing, all of these things. Your choice may be just you're a meditation teacher, you're a transformation coach, or you're someone who speaks on stage. All of us on the highest level, we have chosen to be here at this specific time because God doesn't make mistakes. So on some level, each of us is here for a reason. Each of us has a purpose and each of us has a role that we're playing in either holding on to the old paradigm or building a new paradigm. So a lot of us right now are kind of globally witnessing what is no longer working for us, right? Again, this can be healthcare, economy, you know, a lot of the online marketing that we've been taught is so fear and scarcity based. It is complete manipulation of people's emotions. So the new decade is upon us. It doesn't mean that, you know, we're going to like be super attached to like, oh my God, 2020, I'm going to take my business to seven figures, those dreams. Because this is the time that a lot of us have been, as we're speeding up, we've also been asked to slow down and really reflect on the visions and the dreams and the goals that we've set for ourselves. Really differentiate, use discernment, which visions are out of alignment with the highest vision of who we be, which visions are in alignment, because our world is literally changing in front of our eyes. Like all of the timelines right now are happening all at once. We have collectively never experienced anything like this. You know, where like day by day, moment by moment, second by second, something is changing. An industry is shutting down or something that used to work is no longer working. And none of this is here by coincidence. So partially this has to do with on a larger level that is more invisible right now energetically. The earth is going through this massive purge. Each of us is going through this massive purge. And how can we come back to our role, to what we feel is the highest and the purest intention and energy and creation that we can anchor in humanity at this time. And this asks for us to be able to sit with what is uncomfortable, but to also be able to detach from what is happening momentarily, not on a bypassing level, but being able to hold space for the multiple timelines that are collapsing right now, and to go deep inside of ourselves and see what is in alignment, what is out of alignment. So right now, there are a lot of jobs and there are a lot of businesses that are crumbling. But the opportunity in this is that there are so many jobs and businesses that are birthing right now. And I will say that there are so many areas, like the areas of, healthcare, education, supporting people who are working from home. There are so many areas where so many people need help. So for those people who feel called to be a part of this, really go into your heart. Like, don't come from the mind. Take a deep breath in. Kind of like imagine you can bring your consciousness from the head, which is where all of the old programming and conditioning and lack and fear and scarcity in, and just walk into the heart and feel the expansion in the heart and ask us, what is my role in this new earth right now? What is desiring to be birthed through me? Because I have a very strong feeling that what used to work for a lot of us is no longer going to work. The old marketing tactics aren't going to fly. Right? Like someone who's posting a selfie, like in a Rolls Royce, kind of like, look at me, I built a 7-figure business. You can do that too if you buy my expensive program. Those tactics are not going to be part of the new earth, because the world literally just shrank. We are kind of, our attention is on this one thing right now, but we are being forced to do a lot of this work so that we can shed what is no longer working for us. And then we can create something new for the new humanity. So some of us right now want to hold on to the old ideas. Like, we're asking ourselves, can I go back to normal? Can I just use the same techniques, whatever? The old is really crumbling right now. It's crumbling. And a lot these days on social media, there's a lot talking about pivoting. Right. And personally, I feel the real pivoting that is happening right now is for us to pivot, to birth what we came to earth to birth at this time, that is going to come from a place of unity consciousness, that is going to bridge the old and the new, that is going to really support all of the people in, on our planet, and not just to feel like corporations or whatever it is. This is the time for us to truly work together and come together and build these conscious communities and have friends and allies and connections and partnerships that we can rely on. So specifically, when the old is no longer working, we are kind of invited to birth the new. And this can look very different. For some people, this may just look like, changing their diet, that if they've been on sugar all this time and they're in quarantine and they're like getting this urge to keep eating cake and drinking alcohol, maybe this is an invitation to say that, you know what? My health is the most important asset for me right now. This is my time to change my diet. This is my time to start being healthy. For some people, this could mean like, I've been working at my job for 10 years. I've always hated it. I'm only in it because I really want my paycheck, but now I just got laid off. Look at this as a great opportunity. You are much more than that old soul-sucking job. You're here because perhaps there's a business that you can build. Perhaps there's some kind of contribution that you can make. So use this time to really tune in and understand what ideas that you're getting that are in alignment with who you came to earth to be, and create that. There's no longer, this is not the time to do it. I'm not ready. I'm not good enough. Those stories belong to the old paradigm. So each of us has come here to anchor something. You know, this is the time for all of us to really cut through all of that noise, to tune in and find our center in chaos, like those Shaolin monks, where we're looking at everything that is happening, but still we're birthing something from the center of our being, not from getting caught up in people's stories, what they're regurgitating or what they're purging, to birth something from the center of our being, from the hearts, from our stillness. And coming into 2020, the message that I got that was so strong was all about, bring heart, into business, bring heart into leadership, bring heart into money, bring heart into our economy. I believe this is what all of us are being invited to step into so that we can elevate. So practically, what this means is, because this was all planting awareness, practically what this means is that to really see where you are operating from. Am I operating from fear and scarcity? Am I pumping out a program right now just because I want to get as much cash flow into my bank as possible at the risk of, you know, like enrolling clients that are not even my ideal clients? Where are you operating from? Come back in, realign, and tune in what really wants to be birthed from me. Personally, I like to see that there's always opportunity in chaos. Each chaos presents us tons and tons and tons of opportunities. And the way that we can construct new systems, new institutions, new communities that are conscious is by all of us acting in alignment with the highest truth. So, hopefully that was helpful for some of you guys. And let me see. I'm not seeing any questions or comments. So if you guys have any questions, comments, insights that you want to drop in, please feel free to do so. You can also do that you can also do that during replay, and we're going to circle back. Is there anything that you want to add, Jordan?
Wanted to thank you for the beautiful reminder of just 100% ownership of one's reality. Yeah, it's so easy right now to find yourself in a victim consciousness, because it's so easy to, as we said, point the finger. And if you're doing that, I think it's amplifying what was already there, but it's good to, it's so beautiful to experiment with taking 100% ownership as realizing you are creating and choosing your reality on a deep level. See how that feels and see how much more empowered you feel in that space versus the space of, oh, this is just happening to me and I'm so unfortunate.
So thank you. It's happening to us. It's happening through us. It's happening for us, and it's happening as us. And it's, you know, the other day I was like literally speaking to a few shamans that I've been working with. And I was just like, oh my God, if I didn't spend all these years drinking ayahuasca and going through those journeys, I would be freaking out right now. But right now, I'm truly thankful for those times when the medicine work has helped me understand how to take responsibility for myself completely and not project and not blame and not get sucked into other people's energy. And as the collective purging is going on, I believe this is one of the most important takeaways for all of us, is to how to take 100% radical responsibility for not just our actions, for our being, for the things that we're saying and thinking and feeling, not in front of the camera, but like in the darkness of our homes, right? And to always remember that the message that I always, always, always get from every single plant medicine journey is just to remember who you are. Remember, you know, you're not just this, you know, human, you know, like body with this little mind, you know, with your worries. Just remember who you are. Remember the God presence within you. Remember that you are an expression, an extension of that. And there are times that this is especially the time to lean into that, because we've been operating, our world has been operating from the mind for so long. And that is crumbling right now. People who are just doing mindset work, just talking about motivation and positive thinking and let's just crush it. That is the old paradigm. There's nothing wrong with it. It is important to some level because mindset is important. That is part of the old paradigm. You know, that's just, let's go beyond that. We can do better. You know, we can lean into that bigger, more divine aspect of who we are and allow that to hold space for all of us and to birth new creations. I personally am so excited to see the new businesses that people are going to be creating at this time. This is like people are getting super creative. Their juices are flowing. They're just like, I've been wanting to do this for 20 years and I was stuck in my corporate job. Well, this is your time to do it. It is so needed. whatever your gift is, whatever your highest expression is, whatever your evolutionary genius is, whatever your expertise is, our world needs it. So go ahead, give yourself the permission to be, do, and create what you truly came here to be, do, and create, and not get caught up in those stories anymore. So the last thing is, Jordan, how can people find you? How can they follow you? And if you have anything that you want to share with them in terms of staying connected or working with you, anything in that sort.
Thank you. Yeah. So please feel free to follow me here on Facebook or on Instagram and Twitter at @_Jordan_Bates, also on YouTube. And you can also find my newsletter, which is maybe the best way to stay connected to what I'm doing, at refinethemind.com. So refine the mind.
Love it. Refine the mind. Absolutely. So you can find me on Facebook, on Instagram, Juliet Tang Z on Instagram, and just, you know, on Facebook. I am conscious of the times that I spend on social media, but you know, but I do like to come up and broadcast every once in a while, because I believe that it's important for us to voice our truth right now. It's more important than ever. And I'm going to encourage, for those of you that are feeling that you are born for something bigger and that there is conscious leadership that you're looking to step into right now, because you have a genius that is yet to be expressed. This is the time. There's no more waiting. This is the time, because everything that used to support us, that was an illusion, it's no longer supporting. So thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. And I'm sending you lots of love from New York. I wish you health, wealth, and all of the great things in the world, especially during this time. Bye.
Peace to God, source all that is, as we sail up along the sacred pathway to the most high nebulous, melting to the all man one day, life so nebulous. This is how we chill from 19 till infinity times infinity times infinity, etc. A peace to every soul, a peace to every soul, a peace to every soul, peace to the oversoul, yeah, peace to every soul. Man, peace to every soul, peace to the oversoul, yeah, peace to every soul, a peace to every atom. Man, we just chill on Saturn, once met a loving kraken in realms beyond that matter. I'm feeling like